Hey, what's going on everybody? It's Mike again. Today we're going to look at a brand new headphone by AKG. Now this is their top of the line flagship model, the K812. I did an unboxing for you not too long ago. If you haven't watched that video yet, I urge you to go check it out. There you'll get a close up look at the headphones and you'll get to see what comes in the box. Speaking of what comes in the box, this beautiful headphone stand comes with the headphones. So when you're not using the headphone, this is a great way to display this beautiful headphone. So I urge you to check out my unboxing video. Before we move on, I want to thank my friends at AKG for sending these out to me for review. And of course, I want to thank you guys, the subscribers, for subscribing to the channel. The K812 is a brand new headphone from the ground up. The entire construction of the headphone is completely new, and the transducer is a brand new 53mm driver. It is completely different from the current lineup, the K712, which is an improvement to the legendary K702 with improved ear pads and with a little bit more bass. But the 812 is a brand new design. Let me show you guys the headphone first. The construction of the headphone is completely metal here. It's got a nice finish to it. It should be pretty much scratch resistant. It does have a flexible headband here. It's a mesh headband. It does not have the legendary AKG self-adjusting headband like it does on the rest of the AKG line. It does have these clicky locking mechanism to adjust the headband itself, and you can see the locking mechanism on the inside here, which is fine. I think it locks nicely onto the adjustment, and you probably don't have to fiddle with it too much. The ear pads are completely new. It's got a protein leather ear pad with memory foam. It is a very comfortable ear pad. It's got a unique shape that actually covers to the wrapped around the back of the ears, and the cups are so deep that your ears will probably not touch the ear cups. I mean the driver itself. These are very, very deep. Not sure you can see it on the camera how deep they are. The cups here is a metal finish. It is an open design, so you know everything you listen to, someone else around you can hear it. So this is certainly not for private listening. It does feature a removable cable. It's a locking cable. It's got a unique connector to it. It's a 3-pin connector, and it locks on the left ear cup of the headphone. And it is a rather long cable. Probably 9 feet or so, and on the end of it has a 1/4-inch adapter and then a 3.5 on the inside. My only gripe about the cable is the length. I wish this headphone came with a shorter cable. Other than that, I don't have really much complaint about the cable because it is quite soft, it doesn't make noise, and it's very lightweight, so it doesn't weigh down the headphone. Speaking of weight, the headphone has a very nice weight distribution. Although this is all metal, it feels pretty substantial in the hand. But when you wear it, it doesn't feel heavy at all. The distribution of the weight is very, very evenly. As you can see here, I put them on rather quickly. I didn't have to fiddle with the fitment, and it's very comfortable. I love the way they look, very unique, certainly different from anything else we've seen on the market. Let's talk a little bit about the sound quality of this headphone. One word, honest. This headphone is very honest. It's not going to sugarcoat the poor quality music sources that you're going to have, or poor quality recordings. The of course, the better quality your amplifier is or your DAC is, the better the headphones will sound. It is not going to sugarcoat anything that's wrong with your audio chain. So if you have a lot of MP3 files, or if you have a lot of music that's rather poorly mastered, this headphone will tell you that. It is a very honest headphone. If you're an AKG fan like I am and you like the AKG house sound, this will give you that house sound. In addition to that, it has a very, very wide sound stage. It is perhaps the biggest sound that I've heard from an AKG headphone, aside from the K1000, which have been discontinued for quite some time now. But this is a phenomenal headphone for soundstage and for imaging. What I found through my testing is that on a variety of headphone amplifiers, this headphone sounds the best with the SPL Phonometer 2 or the Lehman Audio Linear headphone amplifier. These headphone amplifiers are professional grade amplifiers, so they are not going to color the sound, just as the K812. So the pairing is actually very, very good. I listened to the A12 on lesser grade amplifiers, consumer grade amplifiers, and I found that the pairing was not up to par, and I found the AKG really demonstrated to me that some of the flaws in those amplifiers and the DACs. Comparing the A12 to the Sennheiser HD800, this is also a flagship headphone, a well-respected one at that. I find the A12 have a little bit more energy in the bass, and also the mid-range on A12 is more involving than the HD800. Certainly it has that AKG house sound, and if you like that, I think you'll find these to be phenomenal. And in my opinion, these are the best AKG headphones to date. Now, for music listening, if you're not an audio professional or a sound engineer, for music listening, this is a unique headphone because of how honest it is. So not every album is going to sound great. I like that, actually. I like an honest headphone. I don't really like a headphone that colors the sound too much. Although, depending on the mood, you certainly can have that mood where you like a little warmer sound or a more bassy sound. But overall, as a reference headphone, and I think that the A12 is a reference headphone, just as the HD800 is, you certainly don't want a headphone that's going to be too much color to the sound. Anything less than that, I think that is fine. Like some of the extra bass headphones that I like, there are moods, that we have, and sometimes we like a little bit more kick. Even the Beats headphones, there's a time and place for that. But the 812 is a reference headphone in my opinion. And if you pair it with a reference level amplifier or equipment, you'll certainly be rewarded by phenomenal sound. I urge you to go check it out. I certainly think that this is a fabulous headphone, and I think it's worth the investment. It is not cheap at almost $1,500 in the US, but it's certainly, in my opinion, the best AKG headphones to date. It certainly beats, in terms of fidelity-wise, beats the 712. 712 is a fabulous headphone, don't get me wrong, and it's a great value. But in terms of fidelity, soundstage, and transparency, the 812 is, it's leaps and bounds beyond the 700 series. So I urge you to go check it out. It's a fabulous headphone. I certainly recommend it. And if you're a headphone nut like I am, and you like to collect some of the best headphones on the market, I think the AKG A12 is one of those. All right, everybody. Thanks for watching my videos. I appreciate it. Follow me on Twitter and Facebook. Give me a thumbs up there on Facebook if you can. I'm a Hi-Fi Guy 528. And we'll see you guys again in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.